You're watching the Physics Classroom's video tutorial series on kinematics with me, Mr. H. Today's topic is distance versus displacement. And what we wish to do today is answer four basic questions. What is distance? What is displacement? How are these two quantities different than one another? And finally, how do you determine the distance and the displacement for any given motion? We're going to begin by talking about distance. Distance is the amount of ground covered by an object. It's a scalar quantity. And when calling something a scalar quantity in physics, what we mean is a quantity that is ignorant of direction. It's fully described by magnitude alone, magnitude or numerical value. Now, distance is a scalar, and because it's a scalar, it's going to ignore any sort of direction change. So here's an example where we have to use this concept of distance in order to solve a problem. It's about reverse. Reverse walks 6 meters east and then 4 meters west, and we want to know what's the distance. So in trying to find the distance, we just need to know how much ground did reverse walk over. Rewalk 6 meters and 4 meters, and that sums up to a total distance walked of 10 meters. So re has walked a distance of 10 meters. That's the amount of ground that's covered by re. Now, when solving this question, what we notice is we ignored that direction change that occurred after the first 6 meter segment of motion. That's because distance is a scalar. It's ignorant of the direction, and it didn't matter whether re walked 6 meters east and then 4 meters east, or 6 meters east and 4 meters west. Distance is ignorant of direction, so it does not affect the outcome of what the answer is if there's a direction change. Now we're going to begin our discussion of the topic of displacement. Displacement is defined as the overall change in position of an object. You find out what its initial position is, you find out what its final position, and you determine the overall change. Displacement is a vector quantity, and when calling something a vector quantity in physics, we mean it's a quantity that's fully described by two things, magnitude and direction. So when calling something a vector, we're saying that it's a direction-aware quantity. Let's look at that same motion that we had looked at before when we spoke of reverse, who walks 6 meters east and 4 meters west. And now let's ask the question, what's the displacement? So we need to find the displacement, or the overall change in position. We need to find how far is the finished position from the starting position. And if we take these two numbers, 6 meters to the right and 4 meters to the left, or east and west, what we begin to notice is that that finished position is 2 meters to the east of the starting position. So we have determined how far out of place Re is when she finishes compared to when she starts. The overall change in position here is 2 meters to the east. That's the displacement. Now, in this example, we're calling 2 meters the magnitude of the displacement, and we're calling east the direction. So you see, as we express the answer, we have to include those two components of displacement, magnitude and direction, like any quantity that's a vector. Now, in this example, one thing that occurs is there's a direction change taking place, and displacement's a vector, and it keeps track of direction. It's direction aware. And the fact that it is means that we need to consider the 6 meters to the right or 6 meters east to be like a positive 6, and the 4 meters to the left or west to be like a negative 4. So in effect, this problem becomes a subtraction problem. It becomes a 6 minus a 4, or a positive 6 plus a minus 4. And that gives us a negative 2, or a positive 2 rather. And that positive indicates a displacement to the east. Displacement is a vector, and as such, it's aware of these direction change. And that's the one part of the definition that makes displacement quite different than distance. We're going to look a little more at this idea of direction change. Here we see a person walking to the right. Every step to the right takes him a meter further rightward. And we'll notice the distance and displacement are listed there. In this example, the person's distance and displacement always have the same numerical value. When we're done, 11 meters. The distance walked is 11 meters, and the displacement is 11 meters rightward. Distance and displacement will have the same numerical value as long as there's no direction change. Now we're going to look at the same a similar animation, but we're going to notice this person this time changes direction. And if there is a direction change, what we're going to notice, it's going to happen right now, is we're going to notice that the displacement and the distance have different numerical value. Here, as the person walks backwards, he sort of undoes this forward displacement. So maybe walk 7 meters to the right, but then after those 7 meters, by walking backwards 4 more meters to the left, that makes the displacement go down. So now it's causing the overall change in position to be less than if he just walked in one direction. So in this situation, what we notice is that displacement and distance have different numerical value because displacement pays attention to that direction change. Now we're going to watch a person walk 2 meters away from where he started. As we watch this person walk, one thing we notice is he doesn't do a direct path from start to finish. Does a roundabout path. And when doing this roundabout path, what we notice is that the distance and the displacement have different values. The distance in this case may be something like 15 meters. Walks a total distance or covers a total amount of ground of 15 meters, but the overall displacement is 2 meters to the right. So this illustrates the idea of path dependency. Distance is a path-dependent quantity. It depends on how you get from start to finish. But displacement only depends upon the starting position and the final position, and not upon the path. It's not a path-dependent quantity. Now let's look at a round-trip motion, like the one you're watching at on the screen. This person is walking 8 meters to the right, or to the east, and 2 meters north, 8 meters back west, and then 2 meters down south, and finishes where they started. This is what we mean by a round-trip motion, when you finish exactly in the same position that you started from. We might say that in such a situation, you have not had any overall change in position. You've not been displaced from the original position, and as such, there's no displacement. We can say that the displacement for any round-trip motion is always zero. Now it's your turn to practice. Here's an example problem. Kent Decide walks 2 meters east, 8 meters west, and 4 meters east, and you have to determine what is the distance and what is the displacement. So let me give you some time. Maybe you can pause the video and take some time to try to solve this question. And when you're ready, why don't you come back and check and play the video and see how you did. One recommendation. Why don't you start with a diagram? So here's my diagram for this problem. I have a starting point, and then I'm drawing out the various legs of this multi-leg trip. 2 meters to the east, I'm going to draw that to the right, just like on a map. And then 8 meters to the west, I'm going to draw that to the left, just like on a map. And then 4 meters back to the east. And I want to know what's the distance and what's the displacement. So when you do a distance calculation for a multi-leg trip, you simply add up all the distances of the legs of the trip. So I'm going to take the 2, the 8, and the 4, and I'm going to add them up, and I end up with 14 meters as the distance traveled. I do not need to indicate a direction because distance is a scalar and doesn't regard direction. Now when it comes to displacement, I do have to consider the directions. I have to consider this 2 to the right or 2 to the east as a positive 2, the 8 as a negative 8, and the 4 as a positive 4. And I have to add up these little distance values, but I have to put a plus or minus in there because displacement is a vector, and that plus minus represents east or west. So I'm going to do positive 2 plus negative 8 plus positive 4, and when I'm done, I get negative 2, meaning the displacement is 2 meters in the negative direction or off to the west. So when we're done here, these are the answers we get. 14 meters is the distance and 2 meters west is the displacement. So we set out in this video to try to understand what is distance and what is displacement. And we learned that distance is the amount of ground covered and displacement is the overall change in position of an object. They're quite different based upon their definition and based upon the fact that distance becomes that quantity that is a scalar in unaware direction, and displacement is the quantity that is very, very direction aware at all times, and direction changes have great, huge effects upon displacement. And then finally, we've learned how to calculate distance and displacement for very simple and more complicated multi-leg motions. Well, thanks for hanging in until the very end of this video, and I'd like to give you at this time an action plan. But before I do, give some ideas to how you can help yourself out, we'd like you to maybe help us out. A few things you can do to help us out. If you like the video, you could just press the like button and give us a like. Or if you think you'd like to watch more videos like this one, you could subscribe to our channel. We'll be producing videos quite regularly throughout the school year. And finally, there's a comment section down below. If you have a question or a comment, go ahead and leave that question or comment. Now, here's what we can do to kind of help you out. An action plan, something that you can do next to put all this into practice. And the first idea is that you could go off to our physics interactive section on our website. You'll see the link in the description section of this video, and then tap on the kinematics part of physics interactives, and then go to distance and displacement. It's a great little simulation with some interactive practice for you. That's a great first step. Another great first step is you could go to our website and go to the Concept Builder section. It's the third choice on the page. And when you go to that third choice, pick kinematics and then pick Distance versus Displacement Concept Builder. Students love concept builders, and it's a great way to get some practice and some follow-up to this little video on distance and displacement. Or if you're a Minds on Physics unit user, you could get our app. It's app number one. There are three modules on that app. The first module is called Kinematic Concepts, and on the Kinematic Concepts module, Mission KC2 is a great one to do for understanding distance and displacement. Finally, if you just need a reference, we have a tutorial on our website that mirrors some of these video tutorials that we're doing, and you could always use that as a reference. Thanks for watching. Enjoy your day.